Hello everyone and welcome back to The Shank is Intact. So, I am here at a permission of mine that I have had for probably going on 8 or 9 months now. And the last time I was here, I was using the AT Max. And it was just noisy as could be. I only took a few pieces of iron until I gave up. So, I literally just got here, probably 5 minutes. First hole I'm digging. Here's the house behind me. The house is oriented incorrect now based on how the past was, because this way you can see the trees that line it down along it, but the old driveway runs right down along here and straight out to the road out that way, because it was part of what I think was an 800 acre historical farm. Okay, but the reason I started a video was because since the use of the AT Max, I am now using the Equinox, the MineLab Equinox 800, as my go-to. I also just got the MineLab GPX 4500, which I haven't had too much practice with yet. But the reason I started a video was because I had a very nice, clean, faint signal with the 6-inch coil, is what I'm using around the house today before I get into the woods. But awesome first signal, and you can even see its impression here. Which this is just dirt, I'll crumble it, but I already saw it and I knew right away that it was a Indian head penny because of the 1 cent and the wreath on the back. And we will make sure to get this cleaned up in the roundup, but that is a beautiful first find. First hole of the day was about 8 inches deep. So there are still things here, and I was right. The AT Max was acting up, and there's a lot of iron in the soil, but it is a very old home site. I think it's 1790s. So that is definitely a first good signal of the day. So we will get you back out at the next hole and we will see what the next signal is. Hopefully this will be a good spot to hit one day with my buddy Joe as well. Get him on some good relics. All right, so second target of the day seems to be some type of pin, or maybe it was seems to have went on something, but pretty cool. Seems to be a couple of little children playing that, like, that old game. Was it Ring Around the Rosie? Is that what that is? I don't know. It's pretty cool, though. I love the enamel that's still on it, the colors. Wow. Starting to warm up, thank goodness. Cold morning we got started here, but oh, yeah. All right, well, on to the next hole. Alright, next awesome find of the day popped out right as I pulled the plug out. Oh, beautiful, my first whole harmonica reed. I've never dug a whole one. I've only dug pieces. Wow. That is a big, beautiful piece of brass. Now I'm starting to think that this spot may have not been detected, or at least if they did, it was years ago, and their detectors couldn't have done anything because the ground is pretty bad. But the Equinox is getting it done, that's for sure. All right, let's get on to the next hole. Beautiful day it's turning into. Right, we're on to the next hole here. I just popped open a perfect clean 18. I've only made it to the end of the sidewalk. I plan to go around it and go back up the other side, and then of course just keep going around the house, because I can't believe the amount of signals that are here. I've actually skipped over a lot of lower signals trying to do some cherry picking today. So let's find out. Ah, pulled that. Yeah, well, that's there's a few of those in here, and they sound pretty good in this dirt. So all right, on to the next hole. Got you out for this hole just in case it isn't a pull tab, but still trying to get used to this dirt here. Even though it looks okay, there's, I guess it's just after people living here so long. Oh, what is this? I don't know what this is. I was hoping it was a coin. Anybody know what that is? I have no idea. Is this the end to... Oh, you know what? I think this is a scabbard tip. Is this a scabbard tip? Because that looks like where the scabbard tip finial would have went. Huh, I wonder if that's a scabbard tip. Oh, man, let there be a button around here. It's a nice, pretty brass. Cool, well, on to the next signal. Cool.
Okay, so this signal was breaking up a little, and it probably because it was shallow, but I got it, got the plug open, and I can see a coin right there. Looks like it could be a penny size. I'm hoping it's not a modern penny. It is stinking Lincoln, but that sounded good. So that's a good signal still here that nobody else dug up. And if they'd have heard that, they would have dug it. Awesome. So the last hole was right there, and I went that far with a little 6-inch coil. And I want y'all to hear this one, nice and tiny and tight. Listen to that, 25, 26. If that's not a penny or something, I'm hoping it's gonna be silver. All right, we got, oh, I dropped it right on it. See if we can, I'll use my hand here, grab it. Oh, looks like a stinking Lincoln. Dang, guess I need to learn my machine a little bit better to tell the difference between the penny and a silver, but all right, well, still a target. All right, so I've worked my way back around the front of the house, and I got another good signal here. It seems to be about eight inches deep, maybe 6 inches deep, but definitely repeatable, high signal, 24, 25, mid-high. I'm hoping penny, and if it is a penny, I'm hoping something old, like an eagle scent or a Indian head. I've never found an eagle scent, so that would be pretty cool. I think I've pinpointed right where it is. There it is. I actually see it. I see some green. Love the color I'm seeing. Pull that up here. Let's see what we got. Oh, wow! We have a flat button. The first one here. Anything on this side? No, it doesn't appear there is, but wow, there's definitely going to be some mint mark, it looks like, or yeah, where it was made, I mean. Wow, no shank, but that's cool. It was ringing up like a penny, so happy about that, that's for sure. All right, we'll see you at the next hole, guys. All right, I popped the plug out, and I can see it ringing. Hoping for another Indian head. That's what we dug first today, but I've dug a few. Ah, just a modern one again. Stinking Lincolns. All right, I won't show any more of these if I dig them. Look for a little bit older than that, but like I keep saying, still a good target sitting here. All right, on to the next one. All right, so I've walked a good distance down from where the house is right there, down the old road bed, which you can clearly see goes off and just ends at woods now. And like I said, it used to go out to the main road that's out there, but I switched to my big coil because I wanted to cover some more area and I'm trying to learn it as well. My biggest coil, the 15-inch coil for the Equinox. And I've dug a half a horseshoe and a couple pieces of iron, ugly iron, but I just got a good signal that was loud, screaming. I thought it was just gonna be garbage, but it is a makeup compact. Kind of crushed, but that's pretty cool. That's pretty old. Probably mid to late 1800s, I would guess. Nice piece of brass right here by this old cedar tree, right on the edge of this road, driveway. Cool. Next signal, I'll see you. So I had a pretty good, decent signal, but a little choppy, so I'm thinking it was on edge, and I saw it pop, and I'm hoping that it is not a washer. I am hoping it is some type of big flat button or something like that, but it's looking like it's gonna be trash. Oh, no, it's not. This is the top of a lantern. Where the, not the top, but the part where the wick comes through, so not a bad find. All right, on to the next hole. All right, I got a pretty good, another pretty good signal. Here for you guys to hear. 20 all day. 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20. It doesn't sound like junk to me. All right, missed it. It's inside. Ah, missed it. Let's hope it's not junk, though, because I seem to have mispinpointed it in the sidewall. Oh no. Most of the time when that happens, it means it's not going to be good. What is this? And just a little piece of some... Oh, a piece of harmonica reed. Nice. Another piece of musical instrument here in this late 1700s Homesite. Pretty cool. On to the next one. All right. Another good signal here in the front yard. Looks like it's a button of some kind or perhaps a tack. Oh, no. It's different than that. Oh, it is not a button or a tack. Oh,
I know exactly what that is. That is a cartridge box finial. I mean, that could be Civil War. Could be earlier. That rang really good. That is a fantastic relic for the day. I saw that just that, and I thought it was a button. No. Here's the rivet mark. There's where the leather went between. Beautiful. Cartridge box finial. Heck yeah, having a great day. But weeding through this iron is not easy. There is so much iron. I have dug so much trash, which I will show you in the wrap-up. All right, on to the next hole. We're going to head down the end of the sidewalk again and head off down that way through what would have been the front yard and make a couple more passes before we head on home for the day. Let's see what happens. All right, got a pretty good signal again. I think it was in the top here. Ooh, is it a flat button? Oh, I know what that is. That's a J-hook, guys. That is a J-hook off of a Civil War knapsack, which means I need to look very good right around in here because I just dug that cartridge box finial over there, so maybe somebody dropped everything they had right here. That is a great find. Sweet! Right, let's hope this is a coin of some kind. Might not be because it's in the side. Oh, I'm realizing I must have been mispinpointing things lately. Trash. Guys, this sound was a telltale sound. It came out in the plug, so I'm hoping it still is what I think it is. Oh yeah, guys, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. First one for the day. A dropped, what is that, a three ringer? Yup. Wow. Where we are, if these are here, I know the reason. So that's... Oh, wow. Okay, so I'm still right by the house, right by the front yard. Actually, not very far from where I just dug that J-hook. So I'm hoping for another bullet, old coin. Maybe a good button could be right here. All right, let's see what else we can get before it gets dark. All right, I thought I'd get you out again. Listen to this signal. Hoping for a coin. It's in the top of the plug, so it's not always a great sign. Usually can mean trash, and well, it's not trash. Well, it is trash, but I still think it's cool because it's the state of Virginia, and it says Commonwealth Virginia, 2 cents, and I have found at least three or four of these today, and they sound just like coins with this big coil, but all right, let's see what happens next. Alrighty, everyone. Well, that is it for the day. I am done. I am beat. Dug a lot of holes today. Let's look at all of the extra stuff. We got a saw handle that I don't believe I filmed. Pretty cool. Seems pretty old. A really cool round buckle. I'm guessing it's for like a horse. Another little handle type thing. I dug this nice hammer, which I didn't... Nice little sledgehammer, which I didn't film. Got a bunch of rings, bunch of stuff. I got a... We got an ornate drawer pull, got a really nice ornate drawer handle, brass, which is really nice. Got half a horseshoe, nice big piece of what I'm thinking is like cooking kettle or something like that. But then we also got some change, some taco money, not too old of a Coke bottle we found over in the woods there. We also got a first for me, an entire harmonica reed, a what I believe is a scabbard tip finial, I think. Or not a finial, sorry, a scabbard tip. But please let me know if you know what this is, but I believe it's a scabbard tip. Also a makeup compact, which will get cleaned up later. I also dug this ornate child's, I don't know what it is. Looks like it's just decoration maybe. We got a J-hook, a couple of flat buttons,
a wheat penny, a Indian head penny, a little tiny button, a, what is this? Oh yeah, a cartridge box finial, and an awesome three ringer, which, I mean, that's just the highlight of the day to actually get a couple Civil War relics with the J hook and that and the cartridge box finial, which now I'm thinking since all these were in the same area, these things probably are all Civil War, which is great, which also tells me that this is a permission that was probably loaded years ago because it's a house that was built in the late 1790s, and I have found some actual Civil War relics here today now. But I will say this. I started with the Garrett Ace 400 a little over a year ago and went to the 18 Max. When I had the 18 Max, I brought it here and I dug a whole day. I dug a lock face, which was iron. I dug a broken horseshoe and about 9 other pieces of iron because this ground is full of iron because of it being an old house. But you just saw everything I dug today, some things of which were actually relics. And I would guarantee there is a ton left here. You just have to go slow and pick it through. But that Equinox definitely found everything. Way better than the Max did. It was almost like somebody came in after me and hid relics that they, you know, that they weren't here before. Like they came in and did it for me to come back, which of course didn't happen. But yeah, guys, hit that subscribe button if you already haven't. And if you liked this video, leave me a comment down below. And if you saw anything I dug that I called it wrong or didn't know what it was, please tell me down below because I want to learn. All right, guys, we'll see you next time on The Shank Is Intact.